we have read about the spectrum. This minor form present with the usually lab investigation abnormality of mild anemia, microcytosis, and in microcytosis, the Clausius differential was iron deficiency. So, usually these patients are put on oral iron therapy and these patients do not respond. So, beta thalassemia usually come in notice, minor form only come in notice when these patients of mild anemia do not respond to the hematocrit. Okay. But in major beta thalassemia, patient may present with a severe anemia. So, feature of severe anemia will be there, like pallor, loss of stamina, fatigue. Severe anemia will lead to the retention in salt and water. So, the volume of blood will increase. So, all the feature of hyperdynamic circulation will be there. Like, patient may have bounding or collapsing pulse. He may have wide pulse pressure. He may have features of high output cardiac failure. There is hemolysis. So, this patient can have icterus. These are genetic abnormalities. So, these are going to present in the very pediatric age group, the very initial years of growth of the individual. So, these patients may present with a growth retardation. There is extension of extra medullary and medullary sites of hematopoiesis. So, these patients are going to have bony abnormalities in the form of chipmunk facies, or there is osteopenia, osteoporosis, and pathological fracture. There is organomegaly, again because of the anemia causing extramedullary hematopoiesis. And apart from that, there are some complications which you should remember can present in these patients. Complication we will discuss in a while. Let us discuss about the chipmunk facies. The two features I want to remember in chipmunk facies is, first is the frontal bothing. The frontal bone become depressed, and the in maxilla there occur the extramedullary hematopoiesis. This extension of this red bone marrow leads to the malar prominence. Apart from that, there is depressed bone and there is hypertrophy of maxilla, because maxilla is mostly affected and there is increase in the bone marrow. So, these bones are going to be get prominent. So, malar and upper jaw will be more prominent. Frontal bone will be bulged and there are depressed nose. Okay, bridge of the nose. So, this is chipmunk facies. So, if you remember this diagram of this little girl, then you will remember the chipmunk facies. So, let us discuss about the features of complication. Okay, if you look at these complications, more or less you will be able to identify these are mostly due to the iron overload. So, the complication in this thalassemic patient can develop from four things. First is blood transfusion. Blood transfusion can lead to the two of the causes of this complication. First is the transfusion related infections. Second, iron overload. If there is repeated transfusion, we are required to give chelation in this patient. And this chelating drugs are not very safe. These are relatively toxic. So, these can be the cause of complication. And these patients are at high risk of infection because of various reasons. So, the complication can arise from the infection. So, if you look at this table, you will find that these are mostly the features of iron overload, that is hemosiderosis. Because it is not a genetic defect, it is acquired by the repeated blood transfusion, this will be called as secondary hemosiderosis. So, in cardiac, we can have this systolic or diastolic dysfunction leading to congestive heart failure. If there is deposition of iron inside the cardiac muscles and cardiac conduction tree, it will lead to the arrhythmias. In liver, this iron can deposit or patient can acquire viral infection from the transfusion or de novo. It will lead to the viral hepatitis. These patients are having highlighting hemolysis, so patient will be having tendency to form pigment gallstone. If there is a gallstone, there is possibility of acute cholangitis or pancreatitis. Apart from that, the drug used for the treatment of these patients can lead to the drug-induced liver injury. In endocrinal gland, usually this iron is going to deposit. Apart from that, these patients are going to have more and more demand of hellan because of the increased marrow replication. This marrow increase in the hematopoiesis. Okay. So these patients are going to present with the endocrinal abnormality. There are two things. First is increase in the caloric demand, and second is the iron overload. It will lead to the different endocrinal gland dysfunction, leading to the short stature, delayed puberty, hypothyroidism and hypoparathyroidism, and diabetes mellitus. Everything is hypofunctioning of that. In thalassemia, there is no hyperfunctioning. There is hypofunctioning only. The bone, we have discussed, there is marrow expansion leading to the cortical thinning, leading to the risk of pathological fracture. Hyperinsulinism, if there is hyperinsulinism, there is pancytopenia, and there is this PRBC requirement of these people are going to increase. Apart from that, these patients may have growth retardation, dental malocclusion because of the maxillary bone marrow expansion, and these patients are at higher risk of infection and they may have leg ulcers. So this is something you should remember. If you look at this is all the more or less related to the iron.